In this video, we will show you how to use Elgato Compressor. A compressor is an audio effect that flattens or compresses the dynamic range of audio. Dynamic range being how different the loudest and quietest sounds are. Depending on the settings that you choose, compressing your audio can help expose more detail in the sound, or make things easier to listen to and understand in noisier environments and with small speakers. To learn how to install Elgato Compressor and other audio effects from Elgato Marketplace, check out our guide linked in the description or up in the video card. With Elgato Compressor installed, click on the Audio Effect button below a channel inside of Wavelink. Go to the Add Effect button, then Elgato, and then Elgato Compressor. Once added, the control panel for Elgato Compressor will open. In this new window, you'll be greeted with a short wizard to guide you through the basics of setting it up. I'm currently speaking into the microphone in order to test the functionality. Here you will want to find the tops of your speech, and lower the slider so it's taking off just the peaks. Once set, click on Finalize. What you adjusted just now is known as the threshold. When a sound signal becomes loud enough to go over this level, compression begins to take place. You can see how much the signal is being compressed by looking at the gain reduction meter on the right. The threshold value you end up using will depend on how loud you are, the gain of your microphone, and generally personal preference. A lower threshold will ensure compression is taking place more often and more strongly. You can adjust threshold at any time. But Elgato Compressor also has some more advanced options. If you watched our previous video explaining dynamics compression, then you'll know exactly what these options are. Ratio controls how strong the compression is once the signal goes over the threshold. With a ratio of 3 to 1, every 3 decibels over the threshold from the input will turn into 1 decibel on the output. 4 to 1 would be stronger, with only 1 decibel being output for every 4 decibels on the input. For a more natural sounding compression on your voice, between 2 to 1 and 3 to 1 is recommended. For music or sound effects, go wild. Attack is how quickly the compression reaches full effect after the signal passes the threshold. Release is how long the compression takes before the effect is turned off. If you find that the audio sounds like it's pulsing or changing in a weird way when talking, you may want to lower attack and release so that the effect is more responsive. Since a compressor like this is actually lowering gain on parts of the signal, it has the effect of making it seem quieter. This is where makeup gain comes in. You can either manually select a value or leave it on auto makeup, where Elgato Compressor will determine how much gain to add based on the input signal and the current compression. For reference, here are the settings we use on the videos here on Elgato Workshop. An interesting side effect of compression is that when properly set up with makeup gain, it will feel noticeably louder even if the audio meter shows it being around the same as before. This is because compression with makeup gain brings up more of the quiet parts of the audio signal without the loudest parts becoming even louder. And that's all you need to know about Elgato Compressor. Subscribe to us here on YouTube to learn more about Wavelink, audio effects, and other Elgato products. Thanks for watching.